afternoon. My name is Denise Allen and I'm going to do a little piece this afternoon using the Cuttlelola Dotspen. This is a pen that creates a stippling effect on the paper, so it's a sort of a pointillism effect. So I'm just going to move the camera so you can see what I'm doing and then we'll get going. There we go, hopefully you can see that. Okay, so this is the pen, and I've got it attached to the power so I can keep going. One click gives me a slow tap, you can see the nib there moving, and then the double click gives me a fast tap, and I'm impatient so I'm going to use the fast one. So I'm just creating this little dotty effect across the page. Suggesting at my building to start with, so I'm just doing it lightly to start with. I've got some umbrellas going on here because there's a cafe in the foreground. So I'm going to make this building behind my umbrellas a little darker, so it's just running over with the pen. It's incredibly easy to hold. It feels much more natural than you think. I thought it was going to feel juddery, but it doesn't. So I'm just gradually creating these little umbrellas here. I'm just going to make my people in the cafe a little stronger. And this is an image from a photograph that I took when I was at West Mersea Island. So those of you who know West Mersea, this is one of the seafood cafes with you can see through the boatyard, so there's a boatyard in the foreground. Building up the dots, just letting the pen do the work, to be honest. Right, we've got this boat in this boatyard, so just start building up the mark making on there. We can see the planks coming across the boat. Again, we've got the planks coming this side, but this side is all darker, so I'm going to start off by just putting those planks in as lines, and then I'm going to add some shading to the whole side. And I'm going to add the shading just by doing, I suppose, sort of little circles with the pen and letting the dots fill up the space. Just kind of adding a bit of shading into that. But if I want those lines of those ribs of the boat to be more defined, I just come back in and just come along with a pen over the top, and it just redefines some of those. So I've got the shape of that boat there. Now, it's quite a little dark in this area at the back here. There's a doorway. I don't know if this is another building or a top. It's kind of a doorway there. Let's reiterate that door frame. So we've got that area there. This area down here is just quite dark and shaded, so I'm just going to put some random little marks there. Now normally you would hold the pen really vertically, it makes it much easier to work, but I'm just having it on a slight angle so you can see what I'm doing. Otherwise it gets difficult to see. There's a dark area under this little building as well. So just start off with some shading. Right, now there's a fence coming along here, so I want that to be visible. So I'm just reiterating that, and then I want this bit just down here just to be quite dark. Now, there's a very dark area under the edge of this building, so I'm just going to come in and just let the pen run slowly over it. The slower you run, the more little marks you make. And there's grass up to the edge, so I'm just going to break that edge with some little shapes that could be the top of grass. Using the pen in the direction of the growth of this grass just to give you that little suggestion. A little post at the bottom there. Right, let's start putting something on this building, some planking. While I'm putting this planking in, I'm also going to put a little bit of shading into it. And again, just putting some shadows in behind where this grass bank comes up to the side. Going up to the bottom of my windows here. So we've now got a little bit of a suggestion of that for the top. So let's just mark where these are going to be. So we've got some window shapes coming onto this building. Continue that planking through the building. So we've got this suggestion of the planking on the front of this building. The roof on. And this area of roof is going to have some shadow underneath it, so again just some little squirrely marks, letting the dots pen put the shadow into that area. Starting to get the roof on the building. And shadows underneath that fascia board. Go over it again, get it a little darker. Right, so because it's very easy to work and it's actually incredibly comfortable to hold. These windows is just going to be dark, and I'm going to do something a bit more interesting, I hope, with the other ones. So this dark one I'm just assuming is boarded up. You have to make sure that you don't hold the pen too close to the paper, because you stop it doing its movement and stop it working properly. So just let it do its job. Got that blacked out window. Now, this window, put a window frame across the middle. I have some shading in there, and I'm also going to have a suggestion. Something like some curtains or something in there. This is the posh window, this one. If you've got that suggestion, I'll just lift up the suggestion of that window there. This window, put some shutters on. All three windows are different, and why not? I get the impression this is one of those buildings that's sort of cobbled together out of parts that they found lying around. So that window there, we have the shutter on. So we'll carry on with a bit of grass here. And the thing with the Dotspen, It's a lot of it is about what you don't, what you're not drawing, what you're leaving out. So coming back to our cafe here, all these people sitting with their umbrellas, having a nice cold beer on a hot afternoon. It's not a hot afternoon today, it's wet and wild out there. But we can dream, can't we? So what I'm doing here with the people, I'm just kind of creating this silhouette of a group of people sat in the cafe. And we're backing it by a load of grass because it's convenient. Okay, so we're gathering. So I've got a couple more boats here that I need to just suggest in. So I'm just going to shadow the end of this boat. I'm keeping them quite simple, I'm not putting too much detail in. If you move the pen quite quickly, you get these like little skippy marks rather than the dots, and that's quite good for those like ripples in the water. A cab on the top of this boat, again being very vague because I don't want to get the details wrong, so rather than get it wrong, I'm just keeping it vague, as long as it looks boatish. things on the other side of the water here. So I'm going to suggest a couple of windows just to make it feel more like buildings. A doorway there. So we've got these buildings going on over the back there. Okay, so I've got a horizon that I want to just roughly mark out. There's a couple of other boats in the water here. Again, I'm just putting them in as patches of dots. And then we put in a whole load of masts. So there's all these things going on. Again, we can suggest that some of these being reflected, some of these masts, and there's all sorts going on in this boatyard, so we'll put a lot more masts in over the back. I had roughed this out in pencil, but not all the details. Now the ink with this is waterproof once it's dry, but to start with it will be, you might smudge it, so just be careful you don't put your hands all over it until it has dried off. So we've got a suggestion of all of those boats going on in the background. Fence going on here, so I'm just going to mark a few, a bit of a battered down old fence, so I don't want it to be neat and tidy. This shadow bit, I'm going to have to make these a bit stronger to make them stand out. Okay. A bit of our fence showing there. There we go. So we've just got a little bit of foreground to put in. Some grass is coming along from the edge. And with grasses, this is a bit like hair and fur. You can just slowly build these up, having as much shadow and strength in there as you want. And you can have some really light ones, some really dark shadowy ones, some really strong. The water here. I want this bit here to be quite dark. So just slow down what you're doing, you can get these really strong dark marks. And it makes the bits in front of it stand out more. Path coming along here. So I'm just going to bring some grasses along the edge of the path. This is all roughly marked out with my pencil beforehand. I'm working with this at the moment on the faster speed. It's just my preference, I'm impatient, but you do have a slower speed if you want to have a bit more control. some grass is coming up the other side of this path. It's a lovely different effect. So I often think with this though that less is more. You don't need to fill in all the details. Just let it happen. Right. Got some grasses coming out into the water. Now in my photograph there are some old bits of wood, presumably from an old jetty or dock, sticking up out of the water, so I'm going to put some of those in and then I can put the reflections in. In out of the grasses. There's a sign in the water. Can't read what it says. Quite like the fact that it's just a different shape. There we go. Right, so we just need a few ripples around the edge here. Few more grasses along the edge here, and I think I'm just about there. I'll pick it up for you to have a closer look in a sec. And you could work with this adding some watercolour to it. And I just want to deepen a few bits in here. So we need a huge amount more in this. As ever with these things, you can always play with them for a long time, but that's using the Cuttlelola Dotspen to create this very different, very interesting view of Mersea. Thank you. Please don't forget to subscribe. Thanks.